Let's talk about the night that you defeated Vader to become WCW World Heavyweight Champion. So when you got to the building, you didn't know that this was going to happen. So when you do find out, were you able to think about, you know, the ramifications of, you know, what's about to happen?
Absolutely not. I had no idea that this was going to take place, because you got to understand, I'm still working my way up the card. I'm mid-card, about five or six, you know, six on the card. So I'm coming in just with the same attitude as guys that are below me. Hey, let me come in, do my job, work hard, and continue to try to work up the ladder. And my head is Bill Watts, okay? So he called me in and he said, you know, listen. You know, my first thoughts was that, oh, God, what is this? I'm going to get fired for something that my mind is racing now that I don't even know what about. And it says, hey, we're going to put you into tonight, you're going to be in a championship match. And I'm like, what are you talking about? You know, And destiny, how that took place, you know, and that's why I refer to this as a real moment in professional wrestling history.
Wow. Mr. Simmons, in the closing seconds of the match, you get the power slam on Vader for the victory, and you see a young black fan running ringside railing, and he's celebrating with a momentous reaction. I know you've met that person on multiple occasions, so you know what it meant to him, but what goes through your mind when you see such a jubilation across that dude's entire body that night as you see him run to the ring? What's your thoughts, man, looking back on that?
You know, the reaction for me is the same as it was for them, because no one would have saw this coming. No one even expected or suspected anything like this would take place tonight. And it wasn't, and the thing that I love the most about it wasn't just among the black fans that were in attendance.
Yeah.
It was with one, white, black, any other culture that was there. Okay.
Yeah.
And back to your question, Kayla, you know, every time I look at that, you know, the feeling is the same, because I know that it was a real moment for me in this business, and the feeling is the same. And I did not set out to make history or to be the first black champion. That wasn't, you know, something that was on my mind. But as it has gone on now and evolved even to this day, it is something that, of all the accolades and championships that I have won, for someone to come up to me, not just black, but of all cultures, and say, hey, you helped change my life that night. You can't, there's nothing else to say, man. You know, nothing gets better than that for something that you've enjoyed doing all your life.
Wow.
I love that. And that's so important.